the Greg and Greg Buddle. It is week six, and we start locally with the Jets playing host to the Buffalo Bills, and you almost kind of feel bad for the Bills. They're a terrible team. They lose 6-3 to Cleveland, and I would think they're going to be taking on a red-hot Jet team, not in terms of play, but an attitude after what happened last Monday.
Yeah, and you talk about an attitude. Well, Rex Ryan has an attitude, and those Jets follow that attitude. Now, they didn't play well against Miami. So you know one thing's coming, Don. You're going to see a lot of deep. You think they blitzed before? It's going to be eight men all the time. I cannot see Buffalo performing anything in any type of offense except fragmentally. Maybe special teams, but it does look like the Jets are going to be after them.
Look for Terrell Owens in the media spotlight in New York to get a little ticked off after this game. That's my prediction.
Ticked off. He may catch the ball five times for 10 yards.
Well, there you go.
That's about it.
That's the major reason why. Now, when is Tennessee going to win a game? We thought that it was going to be against Indianapolis last Sunday night. They got crushed. They're 0-5. Their season is over. Can they get right in New England against the Patriot team that's been a little Jekyll and Hyde?
Absolutely not. And I'll tell you why. Because Dr. Jekyll will be Mr. Hyde this week. After you think the Jets are mad and Rex Ryan is? How about Bill Belichick? His disciple beats him out there. You forget about it. The New England Patriots, you can look for this score to be 45-10.
How often do you see a team 10-0 to start the season one year and the very next year 0-5 on their way to 0-6?
You know, Don, it's a funny thing because I've talked about it with you over the last 8-9 years. It's a fine line between winning and losing. The close games that Tennessee won last year, they didn't win this year. That's why they're 0-4, 0-5.
Greg, this is the one I like to call the purple game because it's the Baltimore Ravens. They're going to be traveling to Minnesota to take on the Vikings. Now, exactly how good are the Vikings? They're 5-0, but are they a fraud team or not?
Well, I don't think that they're a fraud team. I think that they played well. They haven't asked Favre to do too much other than that one good pass he's thrown. He's been unvintage Favre. He's been a control, a manageable quarterback. But when you get into this game, the Ravens had no offense last week. Their defense scored the points. Question will be is, can the Ravens' offense score against the Minnesota defense, Don?
Now, the Sunday night game, the Bears will travel to Atlanta to take on the Falcons, and the Atlanta Falcons exposed the San Francisco defense last week. What do you think they'll do to the Bears' defense?
See, I don't know if they exposed the 49er defense, but it did expose a little of their coaching because I thought that they got out-coached. So when you take a look at this Atlanta football team, I think that they were exposed by the New England Patriots. They played the New England Patriots terribly. The Patriots played well. I do think Atlanta is due for a beating, and it may be by Chicago.
Good Monday night game. 5-0 Denver travels to San Diego to take on the Chargers. I think this is a very difficult spot for Denver. San Diego had to sit on their bye after a difficult game. They're probably chomping at the bit to play. And you just wonder, can Denver go out there and win every game? Divisional rivalry. I think this is a good one.
I think it's a real good one. I don't think that any team has more advantage other than a West Coast team. Good weather, had taken that time off, 2 weeks, bye week, going in to play a team. Denver played a tough game against New England. They ended up winning it in overtime, but I think that San Diego was dual win. The dual win with big offense against the defense that New England had a hard time against.
Now, the best game of the day in New Orleans, two undefeated teams, 4-0 Saints against the 5-0 Giants. And I'm hearing a lot of rumblings around here in New York. Yeah, the Giants are good, but who have they played? This is definitely their toughest game of the season.
Well, it is their toughest game of the season. And until they get to see Philadelphia, I think it will remain their toughest game. But, Don, surprisingly, I'm going to tell you, I like the Giants. I like the Giants because they are more balanced than the New Orleans Saints. They are better on defense than the New Orleans Saints. And despite the fact that you may think this is crazy, the quarterback of the New York Giants is playing better than Breeze is playing.
But be careful because the Saints' defense is underrated. We saw it against the Jets. Right. Everybody talks about their offense, but their defense is a top 10. And with Eli not 100%, you know they're going to try to get in his face. And Sharper just loves intercepting Eli Manning passes.
Well, yeah, but except for one thing. You know those receivers that everyone thought were terrible on the Giants in preseason?
Right, yeah.
Well, now they got four of them that are pretty good. So if I'm the New Orleans Saints, I better be careful who I'm blitzing.
That's it. We'll talk to you again next week.